but he's taking his oath now, being delivered by Governor Vajubhai Vala. Kumaraswamy there taking his oath of office.
ಮತ್ತು ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ರಾಜ್ಯದ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿಯಾಗಿ ನನ್ನ ಕರ್ತವ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ಶ್ರದ್ಧಾಪೂರ್ವಕವಾಗಿ ಮತ್ತು ಅಂತಃಪೂರ್ವಕವಾಗಿ ನಿರ್ವಹಿಸುತ್ತೇನೆಂದು ಭಯ ಅಥವಾ ಪಕ್ಷಪಾತವಿಲ್ಲದೆ ರಾಗದ್ವೇಷವಿಲ್ಲದೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬಗೆಯ ಜನರಿಗೆ ಸಂವಿಧಾನಕ್ಕೆ ಮತ್ತು ಕಾನೂನಿಗೆ ಅನುಸಾರವಾಗಿ ನ್ಯಾಯವಾದದ್ದನ್ನೇ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೇನೆಂದು ದೇವರ ಹೆಸರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಗೂ ಕನ್ನಡ ನಾಡಿನ ಜನತೆಯ ಹೆಸರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಮಾಣ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೇನೆ. ನಾನು ಅರಗನಹಳ್ಳಿ ದೇವೇಗೌಡ ಕುಮಾರಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಎಂಬ ಹೆಸರಿನ ನಾನು ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ರಾಜ್ಯದ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿಯಾಗಿ ನನ್ನ ಪರ್ಯಾಲೋಚನೆಗೆ ತರಲಾಗುವ ಅಥವಾ ನನಗೆ ತಿಳಿದುಕೊಳ್ಳುವ ಯಾವುದೇ ವಿಷಯವನ್ನು ರಾಜ್ಯದ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿಯಾಗಿ ನನ್ನ ಕರ್ತವ್ಯಗಳ ಮುಕ್ತ ನಿರ್ವಹಣೆಗೆ ಅಗತ್ಯವಾಗಬಹುದಾದ ಸಂದರ್ಭಗಳಲ್ಲದೆ ಅಥವಾ ಯಾರ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗೆ ಅಥವಾ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಪ್ರತ್ಯಕ್ಷವಾಗಿ ಅಥವಾ ಪರೋಕ್ಷವಾಗಿ ತಿಳಿಸುವುದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಥವಾ ಬಹಿರಂಗಪಡಿಸುತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಎಂದು ದೇವರ ಹೆಸರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಗೂ ನನ್ನ ಕನ್ನಡ ನಾಡಿನ ಜನತೆಯ ಹೆಸರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಮಾಣ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೇನೆ.
Okay, so HD Kumaraswamy there taking oath as the new chief minister of Karnataka in a political coup in some ways that few could have predicted. Sachimurthy, if you're with us, take us a little bit through what are we to expect from the Kumaraswamy era. Now, if you look back to his first stint as chief minister, didn't last very long, 2 years, one doesn't remember very much. I remember those home visits, village visits that he used to do repeatedly. What could we expect from Mr. Kumaraswamy?
I think, you know, that experiment itself was a sort of very cuckoo arrangement because the BJP central leadership was not involved and Yediyurappa and Kumaraswamy had a very strange equation. Yediyurappa is the deputy chief minister. So Kumaraswamy was on a, you know, journey of his own. He would go to Dalit villages, hold rallies, and they were not sharing platforms, you know, do things together. So the BJP ministers would meet in Yediyurappa's room. They will take a stand on what they will do in the cabinet and then authorize Yediyurappa to take it. So it was a, though they were together for 20 months, they never blended. But then here the Congress is much more organized at this stage now. I mean, Narendra Modi and BJP were there, they would have also been much more organized.
Right.
So I think now we can expect a common minimum program, a coordination committee with all its focus as well as tensions will be there. Who will be the chairman of the coordination committee? Will all the points in Congress manifesto, JDS manifesto will come?
Right.
This will be much more focused.
And Shekhar, now, you know, Mr. Parmeshwara of the Congress taking oath as Deputy Chief Minister, in some ways he's been the sort of eternal bridesmaid of Karnataka politics, always waiting for a chance to either be CM, Deputy CM. He's at least getting to be Deputy CM this time. Shekhar, in a way, though, have the stakes been raised for the continuation of this government, given that it's now been made central to this whole symbol of a kind of anti-BJP unity?
Yes, absolutely, because now everybody has a, everybody on the other side has a stake in it. As I said, with the exception of BJD of Odisha, we don't know what's going on there. And as you get closer to 2019, frictions will develop in this coalition. But I think among the top leaderships of both parties, the compulsion to hang in together will be much stronger than it would have been if there were 4 years to go for national elections. So that element is there. But at the same time, you can be absolutely sure that the BJP will be searching for these little cracks in the relationship with the fine sort of finely ground knife to see what cracks can they widen. So from today onwards, this game is open, because this vote of confidence, even if they win, there will be many rebels, not everybody will become a minister, and there will be many temptations going ahead. So it will also be challenging for the two leaderships to keep it together. But yes, the incentive for them to sacrifice everything else and stay together is enormous.
Now, just to clarify on the Naveen Patnaik front, that I was actually in touch with the Chief Minister's office, Orissa Chief Minister's office yesterday, and what they told us is that Mr. Devegowda had personally called Naveen Patnaik, but Mr. Patnaik had other commitments and couldn't attend. The point was also made that apparently in his 18 years as Chief Minister, he's never actually attended a swearing-in. So his not being here was apparently not something to be read off in any sort of political manner, but it was just to do with his practice of not attending these swearing-ins. Now, of course, we can choose to believe that or ignore that, but this is what was conveyed.
No, but you know, Vasu, Naveen Patnaik has been a fence-sitter now for many. Yeah. And I think the time has come now for him to make a choice. Is he going to be with the opposition, the anti-BJP front? The BJP is snapping at his heels in Orissa. The Congress is not his main challenger. It is the BJP that is his main challenger.
Right.
I think that the time has come for him to make a choice. Otherwise, he will again be a fence sitter, and all his MPs will be waiting for a chance.
Right. Okay. Okay, so that wraps up the swearing in. Pradeep Bhandari, you wanted to come in.
I wanted to make a small point. I think one thing which I somehow disagree here and want to point out is that I think it's now very evident that these people will pass the flow test. So the MLA should not have been locked up in the hotels, and they should have been part of the swearing in, because ultimately these MLAs have to go back to the people.
Right.
So that is one very important point, which is absolutely very ironical here, that you've got everybody from different states who is very happy.
Yes.
But the MLAs themselves, who went to the people, who got you votes, they have been locked up.
Now, and not allowed to the swearing-in.
Yeah, so how is it democratic and where it's very antithetical, right?
Mohammed Khan, respond to that. Why have you locked up the MLAs, Sharad Pawar there on stage? Why have you locked up the MLAs, not allowed them to attend the swearing-in?
Well, Pradeep would be the first to tell me that we should be cautious, and you can't fault us for being cautious, especially after Amit Shah Ji's speech day before yesterday, where Mr. Amit Shah said in no uncertain terms, if they hadn't locked up the MLAs, we would have formed the government. So if I were to put it in other words, then agar darwaza pe taala nahi laga hota to ghar mein main chori kar leta aasani se. So when you are giving a threat like that, then you can't blame us for taking the necessary precautions. Dusri taraf ek party kare agar main 15 din de dete, ek din par MLA todne ka, to hum sarkar bana lete. Do you hear yourselves in the BJP when you speak, Madhusudan ji? Do you hear yourselves? Or I mean, why don't you give up power in 7 states and then come to us and say, acha, on moral grounds,
let's
now
get,
give us
let's
Karnataka.
Let's get Mr. Madhusudana to respond to that, even as now we see on stage Tejasvi Yadav there, along with Akhilesh and Mamata Banerjee, Chandrababu, Naidu. So a number of permutations and combinations of these opposition leaders, these anti-BJP leaders. Mr. Madhusudana, are you still with us?
Yeah, very much.
So are you, Mr. Madhusudana, is the BJP still looking, as Shekhar Gupta was saying, are you going to look for cracks and contradictions in this alliance? And could you try to see if you create troubles ahead of the trust vote? Are you looking to see if the trust vote is
We want them to deliver goods to Karnataka. Only if they fail, we will come in. Because we are always there as the single largest party.
Right.
And we wish them to deliver the goods. They have given such a lofty promises to the people of Karnataka. of waiver of loan.
Right, Mr. Madhusudana, sorry, as you speak.
Ajit Singh and Mayawati.
We have.
Basu, another great image. Yes, Ajit Singh and Mayawati standing next to each other.
Absolutely.
Shaking hands with Yachuri's up.
This is quite a lineup, it's turned out to be, actually. Shekhar, this is a photo op for the, I don't know if it's for the year, but certainly of the day.
Well, we've seen these lineups before, that's what I would say. And I do remember from the earlier, one of these earlier coalitions, an India Today cover headline that had a picture like this, and the headline was United We Fall. So you've seen them come together and hold arms up like this, and then they fight.
Possibly lifting the hands up.
Only one thing which is common here, Shri, is that it is a completely anti-Modi alliance. And anti-Modism is what unites everybody for their politics of survival.
Well, at one time it used to be anti-Congressism. Yeah. So now it's just the wheel has come full circle.
Absolutely. So I'm
the
not
BJP
denying that
is the central pole of Indian politics.
So I'm not denying that. I'm just saying the tenability of this alliance will be how long the anti-Modism can get them together, because ideologically, politically, all of them have been poles apart. So it is and survival for them, and it is fine. Yeah. It is
well,
politics.
There's something almost nostalgic. Is there something nostalgic about this?
Devagoda remembers this last
United Front days.
Devagoda remembers last time I was there for 11 months. Is baar mera beta kitne samay chalega? I think he might be thinking that.
You know, I disagree with Pradeep. I don't think there's so much ideological difference between all these people. Hmm. You know, if you look at them. The voters they appeal to are roughly the same.
Yes.
Farmers, poor, scheduled castes, scheduled tribes. They all also are committed to, a secular form of government. Mm. After all, this is Janata Dal secular, right? Mm. So therefore, secularism is very much an ideal for all these people.
Now, Mayawati and Mamata being led to the
front
of the
stage. So actually, there's far more in common between them in the anti-Modi front than there was between all these parties and, the BJP when they had an anti-Congress front.
Sure.
Because ideologically, the BJP was quite separate, quite different from all the other
parties. But this image,
this
image though, Sachimurthy, looking at this, I mean, this is a clear signal towards 2019. Sachimurthy, are you still with us? Okay, we'll just try. I'm saying this is...
Yeah, Srinivasan.
I'm saying this image is a clear signal towards 2019.
Yes, Srinivasan. I think many of them are new to the last round of coalition politics. But, Chandrababu Naidu had been with Narendra Modi for 3.5 years.
Yes.
Now he has joined us. And then you find Tejasvi Yadav there. Mm. He's comfortably mixing with everyone, chatting up. And people seems to be asking more Lalu. That's what it looks like.
Oh, look at that. Sitaram Yechuri and Mamata Banerjee saying hello to each other, exchanging greetings.
The two people responsible for political violence in Bengal. Yeah. Violence is what gets them together.
Yeah. That's another remarkable, that was another remarkable photo up actually.
I'm actually waiting for one thing, is for all these parties to still call out for the resignation of the governor, because just 48 hours back the governor was the most unholy, unconstitutional element in the whole system. I would hope that it happens, because
not on this
his
occasion,
impropriety still remains.
Not on this occasion, because the governor is the host. But
so
Shekhar,
after
but Shekhar, there's also, of course, the counter view, isn't there, that this is actually what, in a sense, Mr. Modi wants, that it's him versus everyone else.
Well, yes, and if this group has a big dilemma, because if it chooses a leader, say Rahul, Mayawati, anybody, then it becomes a presidential style campaign, Modi versus so and so, and that I think the Prime Minister will start with a very heavy advantage there. But if they do not have a leader, then the Khichdi charge will stick. So there is 12 months left. Which means all the homework has to be done in the next 7 or 8 months. And it's a lot to do, because you have to find a strategy. Do you fight the next general election as many small battles, one in each state? If that is the case, then how are you a united front? If you are a united front, then do you have a leader? If you don't have a leader, who will be your prime minister? I have a prime minister, BJP will say, but you don't have a prime minister, and that becomes a big disadvantage for this front. So the challenges for this front are very many, but still they are much better off united than they were united and dividing the opposition vote, because as Aarti said, the anti-BJP vote is shared by all these parties, and when they compete against each other with BJP on one side, they divide the anti-BJP vote.
They're sort of complementary in that sense. And what Mamata Banerjee keeps talking about, make it a one-to-one fight with Narendra Modi. Maya, can I just go back to you? Maya Sharma in Bangalore at the venue. Now, what we're seeing, Maya, is that the sort of national leaders have given way. We're seeing some of the state leadership on stage. DK Shivkumar there, very much standing at the center of the stage, waving to the crowd. And it will be interesting to see, Maya, is it not, what sort of role the Congress is able to find for him to quote-unquote reward him for his efforts.
Yes, he himself said, let us see how the Congress party rewards me. I don't want any reward, I'm just a worker of the party. But there he was, holding hands with Kumaraswamy in an attitude of victory. And what a photo shot, what an image that was, really. All those leaders there on stage. Arvind Kejriwal, Chandrababu Naidu, Sitaram Yechuri, Pinarayi Vijayan, Mayawati, Mamata Banerjee, Sonia Gandhi, Rahul Gandhi. Right. Is the BJP nervous looking at that image, or are they not? Well, it was an amazing image. Anita Kumaraswamy has been there. Kumaraswamy's wife, who has political ambitions
of her own,
in
fact,
very much there on the stage as well. Father Deve Gowda as well. His son Nikhil as well. Nikhil also has film ambitions, and he has been launched by his father as well. So, yes, state and central leadership at this crowded ceremony, far from low-key, quite a contrast to the most recent chief minister's ceremony, which was not so long ago, less than a week ago on Thursday. That was much more low-key at the Raj Bhavan next door, with just B.S. Yediyurappa being sworn in. Not a single BJP person in sight here now. They are observing this as an anti-mandate day. They say
right.
This is not the mandate of the people of Karnataka, and they're having protests across the state. B.S. Yediyurappa also today telling us he didn't give this coalition more than 3 months. He says it will not survive for more than 3 months. But the atmosphere here is still electric, as although most of the national leaders have left the stage, there are still a few local leaders around, and the crowds, of course, excited, thrilled with what has gone on. Family photos there on stage, as well as the JDS, the largely JDS supporters here, keep cheering, their throats hoarse, as H.D. Kumaraswamy becomes chief minister of the state once again.